So today I'm going to talk to you about using Rexy Wheels as an input into Unreal Engine so you can use them for virtual production. Now Rexy Wheels output two different modes. We output mouse mode and we output joystick mode. And today we're going to focus on using the joystick mode to control your virtual camera actors. The whole point of that is that you still retain control of your mouse. I'm going to try and talk you through it as quickly as possible because there's quite a few steps and I don't want to bore you too much first. The first thing I want to say is there are actually two ways of getting this to work. We actually have produced our own blueprint to allow you to use Rexy Wheels as a cinematic camera actor. However, you can also just use Epic's virtual camera actor to do the same thing. I'm going to talk you through our own blueprint first, and then at the end of this tutorial, I'm going to just briefly go through the using Epic's virtual camera as well. A little bit of background. First of all, I don't know a lot about Unreal Engine, but I'm sure most of you watching this tutorial know a hell of a lot more about it than me. I've actually been guided through this process by Connor from Framestore. He's been invaluable. He's actually developed these blueprints for us, and we couldn't have got this place without him, so thank you, Connor. I want to let you know what our plugin actually does. So it is a VLL, Virtual Live Link type class. That means that our blueprint actually utilises this subsystem to stream the data through Live Link. The benefit of doing this is that you can actually use multiple sets of Rexy Wheels, and you can also use Rexy Wheels to do more than just pan and tilt the camera. You could potentially use them to drive a dolly down a track, do focus, any number of things you could do with a wheel input, and that gives you a lot of control over your virtual cameras. There will be a link at the bottom of this tutorial that will teach you a little bit more about Live Link if that's what you need to know, and also a link to all the downloads and the various things that you're going to need to get this working. Anyway, let's dive straight in. Step one is you need to go to the Rexy Gaming website and you need to download from our downloads folder. There is a Rexy Wheels VP folder. Within that will contain all the files you need to get working. Dropbox downloads folders. There will be something called Rexy Wheels VP. Just download that entire folder. Once that's downloaded, you'll find within there is an instruction manual. So we go show folder. Now we're going to extract all that. I'm going to extract it to the desktop for now, just for the simplicity. So we go into this folder that we've extracted. You'll see in there we have the instruction manual. That's the step-by-step guide. Then we have this Rexy Wheels VP.UF2. That's the firmware we're going to load onto the Rexy Wheels. Then we have these two folders depending on which version of Unreal Engine you're using. The first thing we need to do is upload this Rexy Wheels VP to the Rexy Wheels. The thing I need to do first of all is unscrew these two screws. I lift the lid, and then I have two switches that are the reset and the reboot button. What I have to do is I have to press the reset button, hold it down. I press the reboot button, hold it down. I release the reset button and I release the reboot. It will then come up with this folder, RP1, RP2. I will then drag this firmware onto that folder. That will load the firmware onto the Rexy Wheels. That's all it takes. If any dialog boxes come up at this moment, you just tick yes. So we then have, within the Rexy Wheels, we have these four dip switches, the red dip switches in there. The thing to do is we need to switch them into the position for joystick mode, which is the configuration up, down on the dip switches. And the easiest thing to do then is to just press the reset button once more. It will then load in the joystick mode. There's more details about this in the Rexy Wheels instruction manual. So that's us now in the Rexy Wheels VP and firmware loaded. I'm going to put the lid back on and I'm ready to start the next step. So step two, I'm going to go to Unreal Engine. I'm going to launch Unreal Engine. I go to Film, Video, Live Events, Virtual Production. Here's where I create a new project. I'm going to create this on the desktop. I'm going to create a folder on the desktop. I'm just going to call this Demo Project. I'm going to select that folder. I'm going to name the project Rexy Demo. You will have your own project that you'll want to bring these cinematic camera actors into. So I'm going to create this project. That's now on the desktop. It is still trying to open Unreal Engine with this new project. However, as soon as it opens, I'm going to close it down straight away again. We actually have to open and close Unreal two or three times before we get up and running. Okay, so step three, I'm going to go to this folder I've just created on the desktop. Gonna double click on that. I should have these five folders here. I'm gonna create a new one. It's simply called plugins. If you have an existing project, you probably already have a plugins folder, so you just use that one. I'm gonna go to the folder that I downloaded and extracted. Within this there is the folder called Rexy Wheels VP. I'm using Unreal Engine 5.3, so I'm gonna double click on this one and I'm gonna drag Rexy Wheels into plugins. Okay, now that I've got that in there, I can close down both of these folders. Step four, I'm going to relaunch Unreal Engine. I'm going to relaunch my project. Okay, so my project is open. Now, in order to see the plugins, I need to go to Edit, Plugins. Within this list of plugins, I have the first one is Project, and that's where the Rexy Wheels plugin is. That should already be enabled. There are three other plugins that we need to enable. We go back to All Plugins. We search in the top bar for Windows Raw Input. That is there. We enable that one. We need to look for Live Link. That is already enabled. And we need to look for Live Link Camera. There we go. That needs to be enabled as well. It says it's beta. That's absolutely fine. So we tick those three, we can close this dialog box and we can close Unreal Engine again. Okay, step five, we're gonna launch the project one more time. Okay, now we're back in the project, we need to go to Content Draw and we need to make sure in settings on the right, it says Show Plugin Content, this box here. If that's ticked, that's okay. Okay, we can just click onto the background, that'll disappear. For step six, we go to Edit Project Settings. Now we need to go all the way to the bottom and we see Raw Input here. We now need to configure this here. For step seven, we now click the plus next to zero array element. It now comes up with one array element. If we click on the down arrow next to index, we get this vendor ID and product ID. Okay, for step eight, we now need to put these values into here. These are six figure hexadecimal values. I'm going to give you these values. However, they may not always be the same for every set of Rexy Wheels. So I'm going to just give you a quick step to tell you how to check for what they are. If we go to the device manager, you will now see a list of human interface devices here. If we click down, there will be one or two options that say HID compliant game controller. Now we need to check that we're actually looking at the Rexy Wheels. So the easiest thing to do there is to just unplug it and you see one of them will disappear. Because they are both HID compliant game controller, it's hard to tell which is the actual Rexy Wheels. But if you go to Properties, Details, and Hardware IDs, you get these hardware IDs here. CAFE and 4004 are the numbers you're looking for. Now, if we cancel that, I'm just going to unplug it and show you what the other one might say. See, they've got different numbers. Whatever game controller device that is, the Rexy Wheels are not plugged in, so we can ignore this one. Once I plug the Rexy Wheels back in, another HID compliant game controller will come up again, and I will look for the properties of that, details, hardware IDs. So yes, the one that's now plugged in is CAFE and 4004 is what we're looking for. However, I need to convert these into hexadecimal values. So VID, its vendor ID, becomes 0xCAFE and product ID becomes 0x4004. That is the vendor ID and product ID for the Rexy Wheels. Okay, for step nine, we now click the down arrow next to Axis Properties. Now we go down to index 4, and if we click the down arrow, it offers us generic USB controller access 5. This is correct. We also have to make sure that gamepad stick is ticked. Now for step 10, we do the same for index 5. We click down arrow, we make sure that it says access 6 in this instance, and we go to gamepad stick and we make sure that is ticked. So there are actually two ways we can now implement this Rexy Wheels into Unreal Engine. The first 10 steps will be the same for both methods. So we can now close these project settings. Step 11, we now need to go to Content Draw and we see this BP Virtual Camera Actor. We can now just click and drag that onto our virtual backdrop here. You will also see this small preview window pop up. That is what the camera is seeing. You can also then drag this camera around using these arrows. So you might want to pull it out a little bit so that it's a bit further away from this virtual screen. Step 12, we go to Window, Virtual Production, Live Link. Step 13, we add plus source. We go to Add Virtual Subject. We have this VLL Rexy Live Link here. We click on that. Now we need to make sure this new virtual subject name is correct. We call this Rexy Wheels with capital R, capital W, like so. It has to be spelt exactly the same with the capital letters, so that because this is what the predefined objects are looking for. We click OK on that. So step 14, if this doesn't work first go, you need to basically close and reopen Unreal Engine. When you get back into Unreal Engine, you'll need to set up the Live Link source again, so you have this virtual source here. There we go. We can now pan and tilt this camera. We can close that down. Step 15, if you want to see this full screen, we go up to Perspective and BP Rexy Camera. This is now the full screen of the Rexy Wheels camera. As you see, I'm panning and tilting the camera, and I also have access to my mouse cursor, so I can carry on using the editor as normal. Step 16, if you want to monitor the input signals, we'll go back to Virtual Production Live Link, and if we click on the camera there, View Options, Show Frame Data. When you go down to Property Values, you'll see these numbers change, and they change from -1 to +1. Now that figure there is based upon the velocity of the wheel. So we are outputting a velocity, and it converts it from -1 to +1. Step 17, if you want to change the speed or sensitivity of the wheels, what we do, we'll go to Window, Details, Details 1. Now if we scroll all the way down, we actually have a wheel input here. And we click on right wheel, there is a 1.0, and left wheel, 1.0. The important thing to do here is to make sure your speed pot on the Rexy, which is the left-hand speed pot in joystick mode, covers both left and right wheel. You want to make sure that that speed pot is turned up to 100%. That way that is always consistent, and therefore you can then adjust the scale on here if you want a more accurate way of changing the sensitivity. Step 18, you can also swap the pan and tilt. This is where you would swap the wheels if you want pan and tilt wheel differently. Step 19, if you actually want to change the wheel directions, the best way to do this is to go back to Edit, Project Settings. Go back to where you change the raw input settings. And here we have the ability to invert each axis. So you can invert it there. If you want to invert the pan axis that some people like, this is the best place to do it. I like to leave these two boxes that say inverted unticked. That will mean that the Rexy wheels are set up the same way as a mechanical geared head. That is what we consider to be the correct way of operating in the film industry. But if you're not used to operating wheels and you're not likely to ever operate a mechanical geared head, then by all means tick the box that makes it the most logical for you, because that will give you the shortest learning curve. Now the last few steps were all about our own blueprint, BP Rexy Camera. However, you can also tie this into Epic's own virtual camera. If we go back to the plugins folder in the content drawer, we look at Rexy Wheel Content Virtual Camera, and we drag in VCam Actor onto the project. You will find that actually this can already immediately move the VCam Actor. However, now you'll notice that actually with the VCam Actor, the pan and tilt are reversed. The easiest way to change that is actually back in your project settings. We go to Edit, Project Settings. We go down to Raw Input. And we change this Index 4 to Generic USB 6. And we change Index 5 to Generic USB 5. And then we should find that we are actually panning and tilting the same. Again, you can invert the inputs using the Raw Input project settings. We can literally just go back to Window, Details, Details 1, where it says Rotation here. We can literally just click this arrow here and it will jump the camera back to zero. That's the quickest way to return to a known position. Okay, that's everything to get you started with virtual production using Rexy Wheels. Now, using these plugins, you can actually add a lot more inputs, so you could do multiple Rexy wheels. You could also use the buttons, the buttons on the Rexy wheels to key certain events. That's up to you. This is just the basic way of implementing the Rexy wheels, and from here on you can now do multiple things using them. They're a very powerful tool for virtual production. So we hope you get some good use out of them. Thanks for listening.